Georgia is the number one peanut producer in the U.S. We produce about half of the peanuts in the U.S., about 2 billion pounds of peanuts per year, so it's obviously important to the state's economy. But also it's an important worldwide crop. It's an important source of oil, an important source of protein, and also micronutrients that are important for human development. The genetics of the peanut's been complicated. In peanut, we basically have four sets of chromosomes from two different ancestors. We sequenced those two ancestors independently, and that gives a lot of insights into the evolution, into the processes that led to the peanut that we have today. And then in the last year, we just released the genome sequence for the cultivated peanut. So that is a composition of the two ancestors. And once you have that, then you can find out the genes, you can figure out the genes within the genome, and then you begin to assign a function to genes. Then you know what genes underlie those traits, and you can more effectively work on those traits using the genetics. Georgia was the lead institution in the sequencing of both the ancestors and the domesticated peanut, but there are a lot of partners. But it was a major international effort. And I think the thing that sets us apart from other genome initiatives that I've been involved with or I know of is the involvement of the peanut growers, the peanut shellers, and the peanut manufacturers. There's a strong research team at University of Georgia doing everything from extension to pathology to entomology, the insects that attack the peanut, to the breeding and genetics and to the genomics. And so there's a strong nucleus of people here already so that could lead this project. And just being the center of production in the U.S., I think was sort of a natural segue to being the leader of the project.